Hi guys, my name is Pallav Agarwal. In my last video, I have shown you Uvance XDM1041 digital multimeter. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have not seen the video, I will add the link in the description below. Please watch that before you see this video, where we are going to interface this digital multimeter with PC. So in order to connect this multimeter with PC, you need RS232 cable. So what I'm going to use is this USB to RS232 cable. Unfortunately, I don't have USB to female type RS232 converter, so I have to use male type and then a converter cable, which will be, you know, female to female. So I will connect this and I'll be able to get USB to female RS232, because on my Uvance you have male type RS232 connector. So we can connect it here. And this we can connect on our laptop or desktop on the USB. Now I will show you from where you have to download the software, and if you want to interface digital multimeter with the help of your own software or via commands, how to do that. Let us go to their website, uvance.com.hk. We'll go to their multimeters, digital multimeters, benchtop multimeters, and there we have XDM2041, 3041, 3051. So as you know, this multimeter doesn't have any documentation online. So what I'm going to try is, we'll go to XDM2041 and we will try the same software. So they have user manual, programming manual, PC software, and software guide. So we'll try to download this software. So I have already downloaded this software here and I've already installed it. So I will show you how it works. So you know, I have already connected USB cable on my laptop. So I'll try to connect. So there is a problem with this software. It takes a lot of time in order to give a pop-up that it is not able to connect. So we need to wait for a couple of seconds for that pop-up to come. And then we can select which COM port we want to use, what is the baud rate and serial port setting. So we have to use COM port and then we have to use COM6. So this you will be able to know with the help of checking what is the COM port on the device manager. So this is my COM port. So I need to connect to COM6. And then my baud rate is default baud rate. So if you are not able to connect to your multimeter, you should check whether your baud rate on the multimeter is right or not. You will be able to check that by going to utility menu, and in the utility menu you will be able to find serial port settings. So you need to verify if those settings and settings mentioned here should match, otherwise it will not be able to communicate. When you press OK, you should be able to start getting the readings. So let me now connect probes of this multimeter at the output of my power supply, and let me dial 30 volts and let's see how much we are able to read. So we are able to read it properly. So let us see if we are able to change the settings. We'll go to DC mode, we'll select 50 millivolt range, because T DC power supply is giving 10 milliwatt. Let me connect the probes again. It's giving 10 milliwatt. Sampling at low speed. This is mid speed, high speed. Yeah, it's working fine. Let's see if it is able to change to AC mode. Yes, it is working. DC current mode. Yes, AC current, frequency, period, resistance, continuity. Let me short the probes and see if continuity works. Yep, it's working. Then diode, capacitor, temperature. Yeah, so this is how this software works. So now let us see how we can control Uvon's digital multimeter with the help of serial commands. So I have tried to find these commands in some of their programming manuals, but it was very hard to figure them out. So what I did was I tried serial port sniffer, and with the help of that I have figured out all the commands. So what I have done is on my website pallavagarwal.in I have created an article, Uvon XDM1041 programmable multimeter. You can just go to search and type Uvon, you will be able to find this article. And in this article I have given all the details, and here you will find SAPI commands. So all the commands are listed here, so it will be very easy for you to use this list and create your own solution. So let us see how these command works. So we will use each and every command one by one and see how we are able to configure the digital multimeter and read the parameters. So for reading any parameter, what you have to send is this command, which is maize1:show, so when you send this command, you'll be able to measure. So before that, what you have to do is you have to use a serial terminal. So I'm using Hercules, and I have configured this according to my configuration on digital multimeter. I'm using COM6, baud rate I have set to 9600 instead of 115200. Then I'm opening the port, and then with the help of these boxes, I'll be able to send the commands. So right now my multimeter is in DC volt mode. So let's see what it is reading. So I'll send this command. It is reading 0.0218 VDC. Okay. So with the help of this command, we are able to read whatever is displayed on the display. So let us see how to configure the multimeter in different mode. So if you want to configure multimeter in DC volt mode, we need to send this command configure:volt:DC. You can copy and paste from these this list. So I am setting it into volt DC mode. Let us try to change the mode into AC mode, right? Then let us try to change the mode to continuity mode. Change to continuity. Let's see if we are able to change it to period mode. So make sure whenever you are sending a command, you are using a line feed character, which is nothing but 0A in hex. So this is single character. You don't need to send four character. It is a single character. And in Hercules, if you write LF with the less than and greater than arrow, it will automatically convert this into 0A hex value as line feed character. So you need to make sure if you are doing programming on microcontroller or any of the software, you need to make sure every command is having line feed character at the end. So one more thing I want to mention is if you want to change the rate, sampling rate, you have to use RATE space S for slow speed. for medium speed you have to use M, and for high speed you have to use F. Okay, so let us configure it back to volt mode DC. So let us see how we can change range of the multimeter in a particular mode. So what you have to do is, whenever you are in DC mode or AC mode or whichever mode you are in, you have to use command range, range, space, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, depending on which mode you want to change. For example, if you are in DC volt mode, range 1 will take it to 50 millivolt range. If we change it to 6, it will move it to 1000 volt range. Now, if you want to configure it into auto mode, you have to send auto command. Okay, so I think you have got a very good idea about how to use SAPI commands via your serial terminal. With the help of this information, you will be able to create your own software for test automation solution. I hope you found this information useful, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you very much.